You're watching Election Coverage 2018 from WBONTV.com.
Candidate for jailer Steve Gregg sat down with me in this edition of 2-Minute Sit-Downs, in which he told me about some highlights of his career, including when he was border police over in Kosovo with the UN and U.S. State Department, in which he won a medal for making some of the most dangerous borders the safest after he left, as well as training Albanians.
40 years of law enforcement experience. I've been on the Richmond Police Department. I've been on the Winchester Police Department. I was a deputy jailer before, and I was a border police commander in Kosovo during the war from 99 to 2003. I took leave of absence. I'm also a former president of the Madison County Fraternal Order of Police, and I started the Shop with a Cop program in Richmond, and I'm the only candidate running that is endorsed by the Fraternal Order of Police. The overcrowding, they're going to have to build on, and one thing I would suggest to them is to, if they don't want to build a new facility, build to the side. People are getting put in jail and they're not getting any treatment. Department of Corrections has a SAP program. It's substance abuse program, and it's paid for by the state. And even with overcrowding, there's no excuse why this facility does not have this program. I would suggest the county to, we've got the old Parks and Recreation building up there. That would be a good location to, and close by to the detention center, where you can transport people up there if you had to, or have them go through the program up there. Right now, the jail's not currently applied for any grants, and there's no reason. My mission as your jailer is to provide sanitary, safe, and secure environment where offenders who have been arrested and are awaiting judicial process or have been convicted may take advantage of the rehabilitative programs that we have at the jail. And like I said, there's no excuse, even overcrowding. We can take them to another location. And we have to start to stop the revolving door. Because if not, everybody that I know of, including myself, have had distant members of my family have died from opiate overdoses. And it will continue until we start putting our foot down and start doing something to stop this. I want to team up with EKU, the corrections department, and use interns to do paperwork in the jail. It doesn't cost anything. There's no reason that we can't do that. And as always, my priorities is safety to the public, safety to the deputies. And I ask everybody for your vote on May 22nd.
Stay tuned for all the election coverage at WBONTV.com. I'm Marissa Hempel.